Welcome again. We'll start with the NCERT 4th chapter for class 7 political science that talks about growing up as boys and girls. Now this is a very basic chapter that talks about gender discrimination and how things have been in India and across the globe. So there are two different case studies that we would understand. Let's first talk about what does gender mean. So it is simply we can put up as a biological distinction between male and female would be considered as gender. Now, the idea of this chapter is to explain the inequalities that exist in the society and the kind of power relations that build up. So, what are the different roles that are endowed for each of the gender and how they are played or how the differences in socialization occur with time. However, there have been various practices or when our constitution says it talks about equality of work and the equality of opportunities. Some of the works that are predominantly done by females are valued less or devalued as compared to other works. So that's the basic idea of this chapter is to bring around all such kinds of discrimination that really exist in the society. So the first thing that we talk about is the case study of the Samoa Island. Now Samoa Island is an island of Pacific Ocean and we are talking back about the late 1920s. So around the 1920s, what used to happen there was no schools, no formal schools that existed in the Samoa Island. Fishing was a predominant activity being an island. Fishing was one of the major activities that was seen. Most of the works were learned as household course. So they were learned at the household level. Slowly and gradually till the age of teenagers, both boys and girls had kind of equal works that they used to do. After teenagers, boys joined the outdoor activities like planting coconuts, fishing. However, girls were asked to look after the young ones. At certain age, girls were allowed to go out on the fishing expeditions independently and then weave baskets or cook at home. So these were some of the kind of works that were exclusively meant for boys and exclusively meant for girls, like planting coconut was a work that was exclusively for the boys and weaving baskets was a work that was exclusively meant for girls. So there was a kind of discrimination that started at a very early age. Similar is one of the case studies from Madhya Pradesh in India of 1960s. Now in 1960s there were separate schools for boys and girls. There was no concept of co-education. Then there was total seclusion and safety from the outside world. So for the boys, they used to have a kind of open playground. However, girls were asked to have a kind of courtyard area where they could go and play. Again, girls were asked to go straight to the home for the fear of being attacked by someone. Now, where all this starts? When it comes to start, it comes at a very early age because it's in the mindset of most of the people, this discrimination do exist. So when it comes at a very early age, you can see boys are given things with blue color, girls are given things with pink color. So that's a kind of one discrimination that starts at a very early age. Then boys are given gifts as toys or as cars. However, girls are given gifts as dolls. So these are kind of discrimination that pop up at a very early age and then this creates differentiations or differences in various activities, be it dressing, talking, be it the games or the toys they play, the subjects they choose or the career they pick up finally. So ultimately, the key message of this chapter is the same status is not enjoyed by all. Now, housework is some of the work that is predominantly meant for the females. Be it a female who is working or not working, household work is something that is being meant for the females. However, this kind of work is not valued in the society. So, devaluation of these work is a major concern and a kind of double work burden which comes on to the working female where you have to look after your career opportunities and your household chores. That comes as a challenge. So there are two basic things that are being addressed in this chapter. So the household works like cleaning, sweeping, then you have caregiving, looking after family, looking after the sick people, elderly or children in the family. That is something that naturally comes up and is being never paid off. However, society devaluates them or does not give proper recognition for these kinds of work. Then comes the domestic servants. Now, domestic servants are predominantly females again. They are paid much less as compared to other servants. So, these activities include sweeping, cleaning, washing clothes, cooking, looking after the sick people or the young children. Then you have all these activities involve lot of physical labor, lot of hard work. In the rural areas also, they have to go long distances to fetch water. They have to carry huge amount of firewoods for burning the stoves and so on and so forth. So all these are strenuous activities which are definitely physically demanding, but still all these activities are looked after by the female member of the society. Now there is the kind of case study that talks about the number of paid hours per week and the unpaid hours per week of men and women. So you have case studies from Haryana and Tamil Nadu. As you can see, the number of unpaid hours which works out as the household work or the household chores for men is only 2 hours, in contrast to female which is around 30 hours. So that's the amount of work that is being done which is neglected by the society, and that is the main idea of this chapter, is to bring those into the notice. Now the next important thing is equality and work. Now equality is given in our constitution, which talks about no discrimination should exist based on gender opportunities. Now there are numerous positive steps done in order to work for the remedy of this situation. There are opportunities that are being given, there are welfare schemes that are being launched. The burden of child care and household work predominantly falls on the women. So as a result, you have numerous government schemes and projects that have come up, like Anganwadis have been established. It is now mandatory for organizations with more than 30 female employees to have a creche facility so that the children can get continuous care from their mother, and also making it possible for the girls to attend more of schooling facilities. So these are some of the initiatives that are being done on behalf of the government. So this was a kind of very fundamental chapter that tries to bring a kind of awareness among the society and to remove or to work around the discriminations that do exist in the society. So with this, we covered the chapter 4. We'll be talking about more chapters on political science in the upcoming lectures. Have a good day ahead.